Colorado State. Police State 4 chronicles the sickening depths to which our republic has fallen. Prepare to enter the secretive world of emergency dictatorship. Body scanners, sound cameras, citizen spies, stage terror, and cameras on every street corner. It's only the beginning of the New World Order's hellish plan. The police state isn't coming. It's here. Secure your copy today at Infowars.com or see it online in the highest quality at PrisonPlanet.tv.
From the front lines of the information war, it's Alex Jones.
Okay, your phone calls are coming up, and then in the next hour, I'm going to get into this in detail. Herman Cain describes Ron Paul supporters' concerns as stupid. What do you expect for somebody that worked at the Federal Reserve in policy and somebody who wants a national sales tax on top of the income tax and who supports the Patriot Act, torture, and everything else? Herman Cain ought to love Obama, but there is the novelty of the fact that he will criticize some of the other Republicans up there. And the fact is, he was designed, just like Rick Perry, to go after Ron Paul. And so you notice as Rick Perry's star begins to fall, at least for a period of time, they may try to sneak him back out later. Herman Cain now is ahead of Obama in the polls, 1 point behind him in others. Ron Paul is 5 points ahead. I covered that poll yesterday in a scientific poll ahead of Obama if the election was held today, a few points behind him in other polls. So Ron Paul, Herman Cain, uneducated, uninformed Republicans, you know, think Herman Cain's anti-establishment because they don't know his record yet, just like they were uneducated on Rick Perry, and we're going to educate him. I mean, I got to say, Herman Cain is not as bad as Rick Perry or Mitt Romney. I mean, it's hard to support Al Gore and support Hillary Care and both of them, of course, big supporters, and to be for gun control and go to Bilderberg group meetings. I mean, it's really hard, but Herman Cain's better. He actually works for the very group that Ron Paul's going after. But, I mean, it's hard to be as bad as Rick Perry or Mitt Romney. That's why the establishment puts them forward as the front runners. Ron Paul, undisputed third place. As we destroy those two candidates, he will go into first place. That's coming up. Also, Jesse Ventura calls for NFL boycott over TSA-style groping. We've got some good news from the NFL. You know, I called for a boycott a few weeks ago, and they announced they're going to start groping your genitals and women's breasts. We got some good news announced by the NFL. Not perfect, but it's some good news showing the power of the boycott. See, the feds want to bankrupt the airlines and then nationalize it. So they're more than happy to have a boycott of the airlines. They just don't want it all at once, and they don't want the blame. But on the subject of the NFL and shopping malls where you'll get a good groping, a good sexual molestation, the boycott is king. So we're going to talk about that coming up after I get to some of your calls as this hour ends, as we go into the next hour. 800-259-9031. Also, it's been confirmed the governor of North Carolina was very serious when she said suspend the elections for the economic crisis. And that's been batted around. They have under Bush and now Obama executive orders that we've covered here were for any emergency, including economic or any other unstated emergency, the president can suspend Congress for 6 months. And then under that power, he can then suspend it indefinitely. But he won't have to. Congress has already gone on spending and been turned over to the Council of 13, the 12 members of the House and Senate, and then the president as the supreme ruler. So we are certainly getting maneuvered down a rat hole. We've also got a bunch of economic news coming up. Without a growth plan, the EU faces financial Waterloo or destruction. Continuing, we've got a bunch of other economic news. They now admit that the Obamacare plan has massively increased the price of insurance. Well, it was written by the insurance companies. I mean, it's a ripoff. It doesn't cover pre-existing. It's a ripoff, but it feels good, doesn't it? That's all coming up. And in closing, next hour, I will cover this in the towards the end of the next hour, and I will have a special on it, a lot of production going into it, to show examples of this tonight on InfoWars Nightly News. AP labeled racist for accurately transcribing Obama's speech. Our article went up on Drudge yesterday, red-linked. So we got about 1 million visitors from that. Thank you, Drudge, for covering real news. But I'm going to dovetail that with Hillary going to Kentucky talking like a hillbilly. You remember that? How about Rick Perry literally trying to talk like Slowpoke Gonzalez? All these politicians do it. But Obama, when he gets in front of a black audience, starts talking like he's Ice-T or something. And the AP's being called racist for transcribing what he actually said. And look, it's not about race. It's about people playing folks to be fools. They do it to everybody. I mean, I've seen Northerners come down here and put on a Texas accent. I've seen Southerners go up to New York and do it. It's as if somebody really wants to be talked down to and have their voice changed. I mean, it'd be like if I had a... Oh, we got a great guy from China that works here in my office. Programmer. And I don't come over to him and then, like, you know, put on some stereotypical affected Asian voice when I talk to him. I just talk to him. He's a man. He's a human being. I find that insulting. I've been at, like, Mexican food restaurants with friends before, and a Hispanic, you know, waitress brings over food, and they're like, I would like a taco, please. And the people are just looking at you going, what the? I mean, but the point is, why do politicians do it? We're going to talk about that. Now, the balance of this segment for the next 12 minutes, I wanted to bring up somebody who hadn't been on with us for a few months, and probably 4 or 5 months. He is a sponsor. But the reason I've got him up here today is because he is the oldest and longest continually operated. Many claim they are. I've checked. He's the real deal. And the biggest storable foods manufacturer in the United States. Non-GMO, non-hybrid, and he's making it new every week with giant factories. You do not want, and I'm not bashing other folks, but I found eFoods over a decade ago looking because I kept buying stuff with additives and crud and MSG and 10 years old, repackaged. This is all fresh, fresh, fresh. But that's not why he's here. He's not here to even pitch the food at you. I wanted to get Steve on from eFoods Direct, Steve Shank, on because we're seeing commodities go up again. We're seeing the depression loom. And folks, we need to be prepared. We need to have storable food. But the reason I've got him on is because I promised to have him back up, an update on, because he's buying food a year out. Food that hadn't grown yet, but in the futures. He's to try to keep prices low, he buys food a year out. He's buying the crop next year. Okay? Hadn't grown yet, but he's buying it. And he can give us exactly, as he predicted 5 years ago, already the huge inflation in food we've seen. In many cases, a doubling. And I didn't even hardly believe it then. Now he can give us an update of where we are right now. Steve, thanks for joining us.
Hey, it's good to be aboard, Alex.
You know, I'm ranting about a lot of issues, but all of it ties into food. Where are you right now with your factories that I know can package millions of packages a week? Where are you on the futures?
Well, the problem with the futures, we just had this last week. The reason I wanted to get back in touch with you is that we all of a sudden have just an instant jump in some of the basics, rice, beans, pasta, the grain, the wheat that they make pasta from, as a result of this ethanol thing, our bread wheat is being thrown into animal feed because it's now cheaper than corn as a result of the fact that ethanol has pushed the price of corn up and as a result has pushed up the price of gas. And we've just got this domino effect that's absolutely insane that you and I have talked about before.
Yeah, you predicted it. You predicted it 5 years ago. You predicted it 5 years ago.
The wheat going nuts. Everything is going up by 20% by the end of the month.
Wow. Okay, continue to break that down for us.
Well, what happens is when we've got things going on like the stock market, literally the stock market is crashing every other day, and it's recrashing. And what that means to the people out there is that companies are going to go under, jobs are going to be lost, and they won't be able to afford to buy the food that is already too expensive for like 40 million Americans that are on food stamps, and so. This trend that we're seeing, this perfect storm with the stock market now affecting food prices, with the ethanol and the gas prices affecting food prices, and it's kind of interesting, Alex. The media came out and is wringing their hands over the shortage of pumpkins. Well, I hate to tell you this, but the same land that they grow pumpkins on, we actually need the food from, and that's been going downhill, too, because of all the flooding and also the droughts and everything that's going on with food production, not just in America, but worldwide. So we've got the major population centers of the world, China, India, out farming the rest of the planet for anything they can get for food. And so that's what's causing this immediate jump. I mean, in 1 month's time, the pasta grains go up 20%, rice, beans, some of the basics, and then everything else is going up crazy.
But you've been able to keep prices down.
When we tell people that they need to get going at anything that they can do to get in food, and what we did was this is just an aside, we told people to get their orders in because of the free shipping that we've got going on here for a short period of time. But the main thing is people have to look at this and say, we've got to get food in now, because exactly what you've been telling people is going to happen, what you and I have talked about, we've got the perfect storm, and those prices are starting to just absolutely skyrocket. And we thought they were bad before. Now they're absolutely insane.
And, Steve, the numbers I've seen are 47 million on full-time food stamps that are high-tech soup lines.
Yep.
And then if you add in people that have supplemental income to pay for their food, it's over 50 million are on some type of food assistance. And then if you count the number of children on the school lunch program, in fact, I forget that number. Guys, pull up school lunch program number of kids on it for me.
It's absolutely insane.
That's my point here, though, Steve, is that we're 30 million, we're 300 million people in this country, and we're talking about 50 million of them are already in electronic food lines. And you've got all this global meltdown happening. I only promote what I believe in. And I think people need to call eFoodsDirect.com or go to eFoodsDirect.com's website and get your high-quality, storable food today. Because I remember you for years telling listeners, and this stuff lasts more than 10 years, buy the food now before it goes up in price, which it has, and you'll be able to eat the food later and save money and beat inflation. And you've told me off record that a lot of people call you now and actually are out of work and stuff, and are glad that they did buy food from you a few years ago.
Well, and the interesting thing is, on the people on food stamps, Alex, those people are not unemployed. A high percentage of them are fully employed, and they still can't afford the food. So anytime they see any kind of an opportunity, like if there's something like free shipping, they need to take that money that they spend on shipping and putting into more food anytime they get a chance to get a special or a deal of any sort that they can afford. They need to grab it right now, because that's the way things are going. More and more people can't even afford the food, and it's just getting more exacerbated as this price increase keeps jumping up there.
Well, Steve, I've said it over and over again. A ant colony stores food. Squirrels store food. Wolves will bury part of the kill they don't eat in the snow and come back a month later and eat it. It is a fundamental instinct to save food. My grandparents did it on both sides, but in the Great Depression, major universities estimate 7 million people died of malnutrition and starvation over that decade. 90% of people lived in rural areas and were somewhat self-sufficient. Now 90%, right at 90, are urban. In fact, I saw a number last month that's now 91% are urban. So yep. Only 9% are on the land, and half of those are self-sufficient. We are on top of an incredible time bomb, and I hope we dodge this bullet, and we may. But for a lot of people, they haven't already. It is important to get storable food, and for those that don't know, one of the biggest costs of storable food is the shipping. Even if you buy it at a local place, it still had to be shipped there, unless you can drive to where it's produced and pick it up there. And this is even better than that. This is free shipping, which is a giant savings. Steve, tell folks about, in the last few minutes we've got, some of the different food plans you've got and the type of high-quality food we're talking about here.
Well, people can work with small amounts, whatever they need. They can work with a 3-month supply, a 6-month supply. A lot of folks are working with the year's supplies. But one of the most important things for folks right now are what we call the nutraversal foods that come in little pouches, that all they have to do is boil water. A 10-year-old can fix all this food, and it's completely free of the genetically modified stuff. It doesn't have hydrogenated oil. It's the cleanest food on the planet. It's the best tasting food on the planet, and literally it will store almost indefinitely. We tell folks to use it within the first 15 years for best results. And the fact is that people can put together whatever they can and put in a savings account in food that literally, with what's happening with precious metals and things, people are moving from cash to precious metals and from precious metals to food right now. That's the way things are going, and that's the way that the world is forcing people to be, just for security.
Well, people need firearms. They need emergency equipment, emergency radios. They need food. They need water filters. It's very simple. We need to learn to not be dependent on government, because government has proven in history it can't, and it